being patient and do not quit ASAP is also an investment. So, ganyan din ang love life, okay?
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, kung nasan man kayong panig ng mundo. Ito po ang Ka-Asenso with Gerard and Mitch. Ako po si Gerard de la Peña.
Ako po si Michelle Orosa Ople. Happy New Year! Diba? Actually, malapit na rin tayong mag one year dito sa Ka-Asenso with Gerard and Mitch. And we're starting off really with all the good topics na we can think about for 2022. Siyempre, just like 2021 when we started, and even ito, 2022, may pandemya o wala, gusto natin pag-usapan lahat ng ika-asenso, ika-uunlad, at ikagaganda ng ating mga buhay.
At ikatataba ng ating brain cells, hopefully. Partner, unang linggo pa lang ng 2022 nang tinetape natin ang episode na to. At talaga naman ako, napakaraming ganap. Na talagang dami sa akin mapaisip. Ayoko na, I quit. But in many aspects. It can be in your current job, in your relationship, or yung iba parang gusto na talaga gumive up. Hopefully hindi yung give up na iniisip natin ba, pero parang ayoko na, ganun lang. So alam mo yun, dapat we should di ba, yung pinag-uusapan natin, we should start the year right para alam natin kung paano tayo po-position for the rest of the year at kung how to keep us going for the rest of the year and the years to come, di ba?
Yun nga, and as this pandemic stretches on din talaga, nasistretch din ang ating pasensya, ang ating pananampalataya, di ba? Lahat na nang pwedeng ma-stretch na stretch na, pati ang ating mga waistline dito sa pandemyang ito. And I guess we really have to ask, how do we move forward, and is there actually a good way to quit, diba? And some people also want to go to a fresh start. Ano bang ibig sabihin nun when you quit, when you let go? So ayan, makakausap natin ang ating Suki. Ayan, Suki na siya kasi pangalawa na dito. Makakausap natin si Dr. Lillian Ali Gee. Ayan, isang psychologist. Yes, si Miss A. If you remember Miss A from the burnout episode, she is here with us sa Ka-Asenso. And please stay to the end of the episode because she will also share her own personal experience kung ano yung talagang nakapagpalakas sa kanya and ano, kung ano ba talaga yung nakapagpa-move forward on a very personal note sa kanya. And we really want you to hear that and learn that from her, straight from her mamaya. So ayan, with that, welcome Miss A and welcome back to Ka-Asenso.
All right, welcome back sa Ka-Asenso with Gerard and Mitch, ang nag-iisang Miss A. Thank you for joining us again.
Hello, good evening. Pwede bang magsabi ng hindi kay Gerald at saka kay Mitch? Of course not. 'Di ba? It's not acceptable. So, you know, when Gerald texted me, I immediately in less than 10 minutes, yes.
Yes, thank you so much. Thank you po, Miss A. And yun nga, nako, we're starting the year with you again because last year, our first year, you were our first episode po. And I think we need a lot of encouragement again in 2022.
Totoo yan.
Kaya here you are again. Maraming salamat, Miss A.
Oo nga, bagong taon, ano? Mitch, ang ganda-ganda mo. Last year and then today, well, parang you never age, ha? Daya.
Okay. Same po, Miss A. And of course, PDP. Parang first episode lang ulit.
Yeah, well, parang you never age. Si Gerald, as usual, I didn't even know na, you know, nangaagaw siya ng Yakult ng bata. Hello, everyone. Ayun, blessed year ahead. I'm not saying Happy New Year kasi it's not anymore new, but blessed year ahead for you, for me, and for our country. Ang dami natin pagdadaanan ngayon. Ito na nga, maganda topic niya. Marami tayong pagdadaanan, you know, with the Omicron, you know, and the Delta is still here. And of course, the coming election, at marami-dami pang iba. Dami-dami, we will be overwhelmed and swamped with a lot of things this year. So blessed 2022.
Indeed. Ayan, talagang let's go into this year feeling na we will be blessed and that there is abundance coming, even if parang ang daming ang nangyayari entering 2022. Ayan. Ito po, Miss A, siguro coming into that and maraming ang nangyayari, Iyon lang, parang iba yung salubong. Eh, parang ganito rin yung intro natin, the first, in the thick of the pandemic.
Diba last year ang usapan natin, parang Enero pa lang pagod na tayo. Pero this time, Enero pa lang, bakit ang daming ganap na ganito, diba?
Right, right. And ang mga tao ngayon, imbis na mabigat lang ang pakiramdam, madam, parang napupunta na sila na ayoko na, quit mode na sila. What's your take on this? Bakit parang mas mabigat pa, supposedly things were gonna improve already, pero ang bigat ng pasok ng taon for a lot of people?
Alam nyo, Mitch and Gerald, this is the start of the year, okay? And, you know, the health professionals have been warning us before year end. Mm-hmm. On, be very careful, baka mag-search tayo. But you know how the Filipinos love festivity and love being with family together, that they have stepped over and have forgotten some of the basic health protocols. Mm-hmm. And right now, we're having that. Plus, dagdagan mo pa, recipient din ba ang dami yung mga probinsya natin, ni Odette, ni Typhoon Odette, ang dami din na tamaan. Although I know some governors are saying that, you know, the help has been extended to their provinces, to their area, of course, hindi ganyan kadali, di ba? Like, for example, paano mo ilalagay yung poste ng kuryente kung ang lupa mo ay basa, malambot, at still marami pang tubig, di ba? So marami, nandyan yung Typhoon Odette, nandyan yung bagong virus natin, nandyan din yung ating dollars, di ba? Hindi naman siya, tumataas naman siya. And of course, we know of the coming election. So maraming mga bagay na nagiging dahilan para sasabihin ng tao, oops, ayoko na. I'm too overwhelmed. Sobra-sobra na. Hindi ko na kaya. So minsan, dyan na lang sila napupunta. Ayoko na. Give up na ako. Lalong-lalo na sa generation ngayon, mga kabataan.
And how would you assess that, ma'am? Kung siguro you mentioned the word na overwhelmed. Mm-hmm. And I guess that's a topic then of our conversation ngayon. Is there a time that it's okay to quit? And then is there a time, I mean, what's your view on all of this? Giving up, quitting, letting go, mga nagle-let go dyan. Yung mga ayaw kong dalanan na.
Mamaya, yun love life ha. So, ibigay na yung tanong nyo, love life mamaya na. I mean, say quitting, you know, a lot of people, you know, lalo na I mentioned yung ibang kabataan, ang mahilig mag-quit, tignan nyo. Pag sa isang company, hindi naman yung mga may edad eh. Ang madaling mag-quit at umalis, okay, are the young ones. Ayoko, doon sa kabila may offer, kotse, brand new kotse. Eh samantala, may kotse na siya, di ba? They always want to be very daring, to accept challenges. Sometimes that's good. You know, it makes you grow. But sometimes if you do not know when to stop, mm-hmm. and really be realistic with your thinking, sometimes it will cost you your career, your life, and you know, love life mo din maapektuhan. So ang kadalasan, the way, you know, they program themselves is to survive it this way. Ayoko, alis ako. Walang tiyaga. Hindi kagaya ng mga unang panahon, yung mga seniors, matiyaga, you know, di ba, tinuturuan ng magulang na, anak, huwag kang aalis dyan. Diba? Pero ngayon, iba na eh. I remember now, I'm talking to you, my manager who's been with us for 20 plus years, Sharon Espejo Manzano. Okay? When my husband died, she was very good. She was trained personally by my husband. She stayed with us, with the company. And I asked, why did you choose to stay? Obviously, it's not me kasi hindi man ako dati na nakikialam sa negosyo. Sharon told me, my husband gave me a very good point. Sabi niya, you have to be loyal to your employer. You have to be with them through thick and thin. Kasi dyan ka nag-umpisa. Because that was the first job of Sharon. Now she's the one running the business. Okay? Noon unang panahon, ganyan ang itinuturo sa atin. Pero ngayon, ang mga kabataan, you know, they are not wired na magtiis, na maghirap. So, konting dilat lang ng boss nila, di ba? Galit na, resign na sila. Because it's easy for them to jump from one job to the other. Kasi marami naman openings. Ang hindi nila nakita na pag tumagal ka sa company, ang benefits mo naman ang gumaganda. Not only is your salary, but your benefits is also growing. Mm-hmm. So they don't know that, you know, staying, being patient and do not quit ASAP is also an investment.
Mm-hmm.
So, ganyan din ang love life, okay?
Pero ano Miss A, ano ba yung tamang oras para mag-quit?
Oo, when is it naman valid or better, I guess, to quit?
Kung mga etusera sa labas, 'di ba? Mga marites, sasabihin nila umalis ka na. Hindi ka naman happy diyan eh. Mm-hmm. 'Di ba? Nandiyan na 'yan mga etusera na 'yan eh. Di ka happy, if you're not happy, you leave, you go. So if you're not happy with one place, you leave and then go again. And then if you're not happy with one place, you leave and then go again. Ano yan? Lumilipad ka?
Mm-hmm.
Diba? Why don't you try to make it work? Mm-hmm. Kasi kadalasan yung sinasabi nila, if you're not fulfilled with your job, you leave. If you're not fulfilled with your relationship, you go. If you're not happy with your parents, you leave and leave on your own. Mm-hmm. Lahat ganyan na lang ba? Lipad, lipad, lipad. Maski lumilipad man na ibon, napapagod din. Nag-i-stay din sa isang branch. Nag-i-stay din sa isang tree. Ang tanong, when will you stay?
Mm-hmm.
And try it out. Kadalasan, pag sinasabi natin, pag hindi ka maligaya, sometimes, you know, that can be very, ano ha, that can be very biased, ha. Mm-hmm. Ano, hindi ka happy? Paano mo masasabi happy ka o hindi? Are you really coming in from a very realistic point of view? Or are you coming in dahil nainis ka, nairita ka, dahil nasabihan ka, hindi ka sanay na sabihan sa bahay?
Mm-hmm. And ang ganda din ng change of perspective na yun na versus saying na kailan ba ako titigil? The question is, what would it take to make me stay? Diba? Ano yung, yes. Ano, yung when will you stay and try it out? Yes, partner.
Hindi, iniisip ko, Miss A, paano kung kunyari ang rason ng isang gustong mag-quit is, yun nga, na-overwhelm na siya sa situation or burnt out na siya sa trabaho. Kung ang payo niyo po is to make it work, ano po yung pwedeng gawin ng isang individual to address these issues ng burnt out and being overwhelmed with what's happening around?
Mm. Ayan, social burnt out. Stress out. Social na social yan. Imagine, Friend Mitch, burnt out ako sa trabaho ko. Wow, di ba? Impress tayo agad. Ano bang burnt out? Ano bang stress out? Di ba? We have to use, you know, those are big words na dapat alam natin ng tunay na kahulugan yan. Huwag bitaw ng bitaw. You know, every day, you will be stressed out doing the same thing over and over. Ako nga, on a TV show for 2 years, paulit-ulit, you get stressed out also. But what you should do, you either you'd be stressed out or you'd languish, okay? Parang paulit-ulit, eto na ba araw-araw ginagawa ko? What you should do is to take breaks, okay? Huwag agad-agad, conclude agad. Meron na a conclusion agad, diba? Teka lang, go easy sa conclusion. Pause muna, isip muna. That's all. You know, when you pause, you give yourself time to think and to re-evaluate the whole situation.
Mm-hmm.
So that your thinking will not be evil, di ba? Kasi sometimes you can be very biased eh. But when you pause, you give yourself time to reevaluate and you give yourself time to rest and to look at things in a better perspective.
Mm-hmm.
So kung sasabihin ko, burnt out ako, paano, what are the qualities? Paano ko masabi burnt out ako? Di ba? Ito ba ang dahilan kaya ako na-burn out? So kung ito ang mga dahilan kaya ako na-burn out, what should I do? Mas maganda pa nga yan if you think of it that way because that's empowering yourself to solve problems instead of running away. Because even in a relationship, kung ayaw mo and then you run away, you will never find the perfect person because the perfect person never exists because you never allow it to exist by closing doors right away.
Mm-hmm. Uy, maganda yun, partner.
Ako, don't close doors kagad. Kailangan, gusto ko talaga yung ano eh, yung kailangan, yung benefits ng tiyaga, yung hindi lang dahil kailangan mo magtiyaga per se, but because there are benefits to, yes, you know, investing in something.
Imagine mo, Mitch, Gerald, ha, kung hindi nagtiyaga, of course, full of pagmamahal. Kung hindi nagtiyaga sa buhay mga magulang ninyo, where will you be?
Mm-hmm.
Kung kaya nilang magtiyaga, bakit tayo offspring nila galing sa kanila, fruit nila, hindi tayo magtiyaga? Given, mga magulang natin hindi matiyaga, does not mean hindi natin ma-acquire yan. We can learn those things. In fact, ang matyaga na tao, maganda. Mas maraming hinaharap kinabukasan. Mm-hmm. Diba? So, maganda talaga yun value match ng tiyaga, Gerald. Kasi you invest. Don't think na, oh, tiyaga, yan, oh, naghihirap lang ako. Tiyaga, stress out ako, burnout ako. Duh! Tiyaga is also an investment.
Mm-hmm.
Investment of your time, investment of your effort, and investment of your energy. Tiyaga.
Effort and energy. Grabe. Grabe. Alam mo yung energy na yan, narinig ko yan palagi. Parang yung mga tao, they would rather, yun nga, again, to yung mga pagod na rin, yung mga ano, parang ang question nila is, where would I rather spend my energy? Here or in another, ano, in another place or in another kind of scenario? Ayun.
How sure are you would be better there?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Ang question ko, how sure are you that's going to be a better place for you? For after all, you still need to adjust.
Mm-hmm.
You still do not know the strangers, the people you're going to meet.
Mm-hmm.
Iba yung kinausap mo lang, iba yung kasama mo rin sila. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying don't be daring also, ha. I'm just saying, think about it. Same equal chances yan, ha. You don't know them. Mag-a-adjust ka pa. Magdadala ka pa ng sarili mong ballpen.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? So, yan yung mga bagay-bagay na hindi mo dapat ino-overlook. Kasi, mm-hmm. when you are going to quit and go to another place, you are investing again.
Mm-hmm.
Tama ba? Invest ka ng invest? Hindi mo muna palaguhin? Hintay mo muna mag-earn ng interest?
Mm-hmm.
Tapos, aalis ka na naman, paiba-iba.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? Ano yan? Jumper?
Mm-hmm. Tama. Ako, ano, I just wanna ask again on the balance of that. When is it daring, an act of courage? And when is it, yun nga, you've answered actually when it's a giving up kind of scenario from a negative mindset. When is it daring na? When is it something that actually benefits you? Is there a scenario that when you quit, it actually might benefit you to a certain extent?
Okay. I will tell you two examples.
Mm-hmm.
When it is already affecting my mental health. For example, kung nandyan na, nakikita mong boss mo, natatapo na yung kape, nanginginig ka na, hindi ka na makasalita, mm-hmm. nag-stutter ka na, okay, you have sweaty hands, hindi ka makagawa ng report.
Mm-hmm.
If it's affecting your mental health, I'm just saying, time to reevaluate.
Mm-mm.
Okay?
Mm-mm.
But if you're patient, for example, I heard one, ano, etchusera ko eh. Before the pandemic.
Mm-mm.
I heard, because I'm on TV, so some people, one good yaya told me, it's very reliable, she told me, alam mo, when I was working with you, okay, when I was working for my amo, okay, marami nang kumukuha sa kanya. Foreigner, kasi she's very good. Eh. She's really a very competent na worker. Muna sabihin anong trabaho, maski she's a very competent worker. So many people are offering her jobs, foreigners pa, offering her to travel with them, gano'n. But she decided she wants to stick with her employer.
Mm-hmm.
And since she stick with her employer, she's also been to Europe, anywhere else. Mm-hmm. Her salary is also not very low. And she get to be compensated because she has a health plan.
Mm-hmm.
Now, had she not stayed with her employer and work abroad, oo nga, malaking kikitain mo, mauubos din.
Mm-hmm.
Tama? Malaking kikitain mo, pero may health plan ka ba? Sa kanya, may health plan na din siya. Anytime she feels she's sick, she just brings her card, flash it to the hospital, free na.
Wow.
Many times, we will think, you know, ito ay mahirap. Kasi ito ang nagpapahirap sa atin. But sa totoo lang, isipin natin, kung ito ay nagpapahirap sa atin, how can we make it better? We have to understand how can we make it better. Because if we find the reason on how to make it better, then that is equipping you to solve your own problems.
Right, right.
Mm.
Tama.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
ang ganda.
Meron ka ba?
Siguro ang ano ko, kasi ang magandang message kasi sa atin ni Miss A, if you're feeling down right now, it's not really a good idea to quit kung medyo mababaw ang dahilan. Ngayon, if I decide to stay, if I decide not to quit, ano yung magandang mindset para hindi yung napilitan lang ako, sige na nga, wag na, hindi na ako alis. Ano yung magandang mindset para productive ako dun sa, let's say, sa trabaho or sa relasyon na kung saan ako mag-stay?
Never put it in your mind, nagtitiis ako. Mm-hmm. You're not suffering at all. Okay? I am giving it a chance. I will do my best to work it out. When you do that, you empower. It's the I message. It's not na nagtsatsaga ako kasi wala na, kasi kailangan ko sweldo. Nagtsatsaga ako, no. Nagtsatsaga, parang nililimos mo pa eh. No need. This is my decision to stay. I will make it work. I will do my best to make it work. Whenever I feel down, I will go out for a break.
Right.
For a recess. I will pause before I sit down again on my table. Mm-hmm. Yan din ang ano yan ang sinasabi ko na when you feel so burnt out, stress out sa trabaho mo, step up. Wala mo magagalit, tumayo ka sa silya mo, maglakad ah. Mm-hmm. Not unless magtago ka sa comfort room ng 3 hours at sumabay na lang sa break time at uwian. Diba? Wala na mo magagalit sa iyo. You're free to take a break.
Right, right.
Take a coffee break while you sip coffee. You can think of many things. Mm-hmm. When you talk with your friends, like me and my friends, when professionals get together, we don't talk about our clients. Number two, we don't talk about our job. Even if they say, oh, you're on TV like that. Ah, yeah. Ganun natin. We talk about our chika-chika days on St. Paul's. Diba? Yeah. Yung parang, okay. Alam mo, ano sa St. Paul's? Kamukha kang syonga. Ay, ikaw din. Diba? Dalawa tayong syonga. O, diba? You know, when you are outside of your workplace, try not anymore to stick to what you should do. If you're at home from your workplace, throw your workloads or your work mindset outside the door. Sasabi nila, mahirap. Talaga naman mahirap. Wala naman madali eh. But right. It's an intentional behavior that you should do.
Mm-mm. Actually, that was my next question. And I think this is one of the difficulties then. Lalo na, hindi naman natin maikakaila na ang work from home setup has removed boundaries that used to be available. Yung mga coffee breaks, yung mga lakad muna tayo sa labas, ganyan. Sunod-sunod na yung mga meetings and suddenly everyone's taking your schedule by the minute na, di ba? Versus are you physically available? Wala nang ganun. How do you take a break properly? Kasi ang laging sinasabi ngayon at ang mga narinig natin is that bi-break nga ako, babalik naman ako sa trabaho, isipin ko pa kung paano ko tatapusin. Nandun pa rin yun. It hangs over me like a cloud, di ba? How do you go against that or solve that kind of anxiety na may babalikan ka pang trabaho pagkatapos ng break?
Maganda yung sinabi mo, Mitch. Ayan na naman. Paano ako makaka-break? Kailangan akong bumalik, tapusin trabaho ko.
Mm-hmm.
The negative thoughts, the negative mindset, the negative thought waves.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi ba? I am going to take a break. Mamaya, tatapusin ko yung trabaho ko. Kung hindi ko matapos, gagawin ko kung anong kaya ko lang. At least, nabawasan pa. Bukas, kung may bagong tambak na trabaho, hindi ako matatambakan kasi nababawasan ako. May natatapos ako. Diba? The way we think, it's very important because the way we think, especially when we say it out, naku, very dangerous yun. Parang, Mitch, ano ba naman to? Magko-coffee break ako, pagbalik ko, dami-dami akong trabaho, dami tambak. Why say tambak? It's your responsibility. Naku, magko-coffee break ako. Pagbalik ko, I will try my best na tapusin. Kung hindi ko matapos yung 10, I will do my best tapusin yung kaya kong tapusin. Diba? Everybody deserves that. So why do you want to put a negative mindset? Especially when you say it, hindi siya maganda.
So change the way we think. And then, is there a focus dapat pag nagbe-break? Gusto ko yung chika eh. Kasi nakaka-refresh talaga yun. Sa totoo lang. Cheese.
Do you know that when I give, mga mariptes tayo, when I give a seminar, okay, I always, even if it's an hour and a half, I always give them 5 or 10 minutes break. I'm the number one marites. When they come back, I will ask them, so what did you do for the last 10 minutes? Iba nagluto, iba nag-ulta. Oh, di ba? Maganda nga, aside from the talk I'm giving, nakipag-chismisan pa ako sa kanila. Ano niluto mo? Kasi ba, paano mo niluto yan? That is all, not because I want, not because, you know, I love it. Okay? Not because it has to be, but because it's so nice you get to connect with one another and you get to disconnect for a moment something that is heavy.
Mm-mm.
Okay? So it's so nice to this. Why, even playing with your dogs is nice. Diba? Even playing with your brushes is nice. Even, you know, play with your phone, it's nice lang. Just for a few minutes, you can, if you, something's too heavy, you shake it off. Ako, if it's too heavy the day, counseling, I shake it off. I stand up, I walk around my room. If no, shake it off.
Right.
You have to really cut it. Kumbaga, o intentionally gupitin mo yung thoughts na yan. Diba? Masarap nga yung parang, like for example, tayo, kanina when we started, diba, everybody was busy. And they say, oh, Gerald, anong ginagawa mo with Yakult? It's so nice. Now we learn, diba? Gusto niya Yakult. But it's also one way of connecting with one another. It's one way of knowing you and knowing me. Ay, parang kumanta ako ah.
Diba?
Knowing you and knowing me, diba? And it's also a good way. It's also a good way for us to let out some steam and let out some stress of the day. Smiling, diba?
Correct.
Ito, Miss Amy, tanong ako since New Year ngayon. Ang dami nangyayari, nakaka-overwhelm. Ano message nyo sa aming lahat? How do we get going?
Alam nyo po, ang buhay ay mahirap. I will not promise you that things will be better. I will not say that. I dare not say that. Diba? Di ko nga alam sino iboboto nyo, diba? Hindi nyo alam sino iboboto ko. Diba? Pero, all I can say is, we are not given this task ng hindi natin kaya. Believe me. When we say hindi ko kaya, sabi natin. Hindi yan sinasabi na may kapal. Diba? I remember I said a few weeks ago, last week, learning to say no, learning to quit, okay, para sa akin, someone who can do that, it takes a strong person to do that. Why? Because it takes a strong person to say no, tama na, my time are valuable, mahalaga energy ko, mahal ko sarili ko, I have to stop, or I have to pause, or I have to let go. Tatlo lang yan eh. You leave, you let go, you quit, you pause, okay? Or do you just let it go? You continue doing it. Kaya sinasabi ko, ang buhay mahirap. I'm not promising you something good. Maski sinong umupo na bagong presidente, imagine ililinis niya itong kalat for how many years. But remember, kaya natin to. Just do not let go. Let go of what? Of your hope, of your belief, and of your faith. Hang on to it. Alam nyo ba, sabi nga sa Psychological Association, hindi Psychological, na Philippines, American Psychological Association, APA, the peak wherein people prayed, okay, prayers, the peak of prayers were during March of 2020. That was the start of the pandemic.
Oo.
Sabi ko, wow, nagdasal mga kano, di ba? Sila ang hindi pwede na magdasal sa classroom. Pero ang survey says, ting! Ang peak ng people praying was during March of 2020. That was the peak.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Okay.
Sana tinuloy nila. Continue.
Kaya nga eh, sabi ko, you hang on to your belief and whatever faith you have, hang on to it. It's better you are hanging on to something than nothing. Dadapa ka, mahuhulog ka. Hang on. Kapit lang. Tatawid tayo din. Okay, good or bad president, next one, tatawirin natin. Nakatawid na, tumatawid na tayo eh. Tatawid din tayo.
Right. And ganun naman every circumstance. At the start, it's always the most daunting. It's always the most anxious part. And then eventually, you get through it as well.
Oo. Kasi our brain is not wired to right away deal with problems. Alam nyo ba, Michan? Ang brain natin, hindi yan wired na pag, oops, problema, ito solve ko. We're not wired that way. We're not wired that way. Kaya kung may problema, nagaganyan tayo, di ba? Parang ano ito? Bakit ito? Remember during the March, the pandemic, I was thinking it's just a week, eh, di ba? It's just 3 days, eh. It's just 1 week, eh. Tapos 1 month, aba, okay, 2 months lang to. Until now, we don't even have the right pill or the right medicine for COVID. And it's more than 1 year.
Oo, mag-ano na tayo.
Mag-3 years.
2 years. 3 years
na, we're in the second. Oo, imagine, di ba? We're running on the onga, di ba?
So yun. Okay. Season 3 na tayo. Ito, I'm just, I'm curious about this. So, when itong learning to say no and that it takes a strong person to do it, are you saying, ma'am, that the pause is the quit, or how do we properly, ano, how does it become something na that comes from a position of strength instead of hopelessness, instead of despair?
You know, pausing is good. It means to say, I am telling you that my energy and myself is important.
Mm-hmm.
But when you let go, I want to say it in a very nice way. When you want to go and quit, don't try to look back anymore too much. Mm-hmm. Just like, di ba, when we're driving Mitch, ano ang malaking salamin? Hindi ba yung windshield na, yung mirror natin sa harapan, di ba? Sasakyan natin, di ba? Shield yan, di ba? Ano ang maliit? Yung mirror natin dito. Ang mirror natin dito is small. It's only for us to, from time to time, look at the back para safe tayo.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning to say, in life, you look back a little to learn lessons from your past.
Mm-hmm.
But you look forward to your future.
Nice.
Using this big glass. Mm-hmm. Diba? You need to look back to check on what you have done wrong so that you don't repeat it again.
Mm-hmm.
But when you have decided to quit and move forward, don't keep on looking back and looking back and looking back. Mababangga ka rin. Mm-hmm. Sayang din you quit.
Right.
Diba? That's why I said, it takes a strong person, a courageous person to say, I quit. Kasi talaga, it's a decision. Mm-hmm. Ayoko na. Tama na.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But in the same way, if you decide, I quit, thinking about leaving the company or leaving a relationship, then be strong enough. Be strong enough to be courageous enough to make that decision of yours work.
Mm-hmm. And nandun ulit tayo na kailangan nandun ka na sa how do I make it work? Or what
will yes, how do I make it work? Mm-hmm. And then, not only how do I make it work, is it doable? Is it realistic?
Mm.
Diba? Iba yun, is it realistic? Is it doable? Iba yun, ha?
Oh, oh,
iba yun, nag-i-imagine ka, magbabago siya dahil sa akin. Ay, pag tinakot ko, baka iwanan. Pag tinakot ko, baka magbago. Ay, don't do that, ha? It's not right. Ano yan, bata? Diba? Don't go into those kind of thing, no? Na baka pag tinakot ko, magbago. Baka sabihin ko, mag-break kami, magbago. Ay, hindi siya mag-break. Magbabago siya agad-agad ngayon. Pero bukas, ibalik na naman siya. If there are issues, work it out. Do not let it stay long.
Yes. Ako, one last thought. Tips lang for those who are in the middle of re-evaluating. How do you properly frame that re-evaluation para kung ano man yung decision mo moving forward? How do you properly re-evaluate para hindi na yon, again, removing yung hopelessness or removing any form of other despair?
Parang na-pick up ko kanina sa sinabi mo, Mitch. When you are going through an emotional roller coaster or if you are feeling da-da-da-da-da-da-da, hold it.
Mm-mm.
Don't make any decision.
Mm-mm.
Pause lang.
Right.
You can always come back for it. But you don't have to deal with it now. Mm-hmm. Pwede mong balikan, hindi mo kailangan sagutin ngayon.
Yun yung biggest talaga. Pause talaga.
Pause talaga. Kasi, when we pause, we can see the bigger picture.
Mm-hmm.
For example, when, you know, I learned a lot when my husband died. I can always close myself and keep myself in my room.
Mm-hmm.
But if I do that, I will not see the many helping hands there, reaching out to help me, reaching out saying, Ali, I'm here for you. I will be here for your family. What can I do?
Mm-hmm.
If I kept to myself, will I do better? No.
Mm-hmm.
But knowing, I see those caring people, their helping hands, hindi nga tayo makakonect, di ba? But ang dami kong messages, what can I do for you? What do you need? How can I help you? Mm-hmm. They are reaching out to help me. Pero kung kinulong ko sarili ko, hindi ko makikita. So importante talaga sa atin talaga, tandaan natin, wag paggalit tayo, nasasaktan tayo, naiirita tayo, hold it.
Mm-hmm.
Control your emotions. Do not let your emotions control you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That's yours. Ikaw dapat may hawak. Control your emotions. Hold it. Don't make decisions now. Let it go. Let it pass. Okay? I-freeze mo. Frozen. I-freeze mo siya. Diba? Do not make decisions habang may nararamdaman ka.
Mm-hmm.
Eh, pwede pag ganun, ibalalo din yun. Diba? Mm-hmm. Hold it. You are not obliged to make any decision when you are not okay.
Mm-hmm.
You have all the right to say, pag-iisipan ko po ito.
Mm-hmm. So, thank you so much, Miss A. Ito, if there is someone right now watching na on, ano na, ando na siya na, ayoko na.
On the brink of saying, I quit.
Yeah. On the brink of saying it or talagang pinagsasabukas na lang pero yun na yung sasabihin niya. and it's in that space na overwhelmed, yung overwhelmed na talagang, kasi merong ganun, di ba? Yung emotional ka na and then hindi ka makaalis pa dun sa state na yun, no matter how many pauses you take. What would you advise that person?
Kaibigan, hindi ka nag-iisa.
Mm-hmm.
We are here to help one another. Huwag mong isipin, kami ang tumutulong sa inyo. Dahil balang araw, malay mo, kayo din ang tutulong sa amin. Let's reach out. You're not alone.
Mm-hmm.
We are here. We will help one another.
Mm-hmm.
This may be our time. Maybe next time you will be able to help us or help another person. But again, you're not alone. Many people care and will really exert effort and energy to help and assist. You're not alone. Don't give up. Don't give up. It's not worth to give it up. It's worth to fight for it.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm. And then Miss A, on your own personal note, how did you go on? What made you go on? You already mentioned it several times about your husband, but how do you move on from that and how are you carrying on from that?
I will say I have not gotten over the loss.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I mentioned it's like swimming, you know, in a very, very dark black ocean. I don't know where the shore is.
Mm-hmm.
I am alone.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where I'm going. I cannot see the shore. All I can see is the pitch darkness of the sky.
Mm-hmm.
But I know because I hang on to my faith and belief that one day, I will be able to see the sight of the shore. May not be today, may not be tomorrow, but I know it will happen. Why? Because I believe and I hang on to my faith. Mm-hmm. So it's very important we pray. Diba? Mm-hmm. If we pray, we tell God everything. God hears us.
Mm-hmm.
So ako talaga, my strength is prayers.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, my prayer, my Bible study group friends who would always pray for me. Knowing someone is praying for you, malaking bagay yun. It gives you the added strength. Diba? So malaking bagay. But of course, you need to pray for yourself. But prayers, hanging on to the Lord. And of course, you have to surround yourself with positive people. Hindi na naman positivity, ha? Positive people who will encourage you, who will be there to listen to you.
Mm-hmm.
Yun. And to me, those are my Bible study group.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, people supportive.
Yes, thank you so much, Miss A. And we're so grateful to have you at this time and that you could even come here and tell us about it. It's already a testimony of strength talaga. And grabe, unimaginable grace din talaga ni Lord sa life mo. So thank you so much.
Thank you very, very much. Next year again.
Next
I
year.
I hope I'm still beautiful because Mitch is so beautiful.
Ay, grabe.
Last year ganyan na siya. Last year ganyan na, ganun pa ngayon.
Correct.
Have a blessed year ahead. And again, kaya natin ito. Remember, prepare yourself well, arm yourself well. Kaya natin ito. Distancing muna.
Distancing muna.
Hindi, okay lang. Okay lang, distancing muna. Maging taray-taray muna tayo. Hindi tayo magkakilala muna. Because you have to take care of yourself,
yeah,
your
right,
family,
right,
and the people around you. So, distancing muna tayo.
Okay. Where can they reach you, Miss A? Or where can they, ano, contact you or find out your next guestings?
Oh, kasi I have a YouTube channel eh. So they can go to my YouTube channel and I check on it naman eh.
Yeah, just we'll put the link down below para makita.
Yeah, I gave na Gerald, di ba, no?
Yes.
Thank you very,
thank
very
you.
Much.
Thank you. Happy New Year, Miss A. Thank and you. We are so, so glad to have you. Thank you.
Stay safe. Thank
ingat
you.
Ingat lagi. All right, thank you again, Miss A. Napaka-insightful as always ni Miss A. Ano? Ito, partner, ang pinakamalaking takeaway ko lang dyan. Yun nga, wag basta-basta magkukwit. And if you don't quit, if you decide to stay, huwag mo isipin na ano, nagtsatsaga ka lang.
Mm-mm.
Dapat isipin mo, hindi, ilalaban ko to. This is worth my time. This is worth my effort. Mm-hmm. At ito ilalaban ko para maging maganda yung relasyon, or maganda yung maging trabaho ko, or maganda yung kalabasan nitong endeavor na ito, di ba? Mm-hmm. Ganun lang kasimple yung naisip ko na magandang takeaway dito. So kung kayo po, kung nakakaisip kayo mag-quit ngayon, mag-quit sa trabaho, mag-quit sa isang relasyon, ako, pag-isipan nyo po na makailang ulit, hindi maganda yung magde-decide tayo na, I quit! Kapag ka, ano ka, kapag ka highly emotional ka, yung ikaw ay punong-puno ng galit at poot, or ikaw ay lungkot na lungkot, let it let it simmer down, let it die down a bit bago ka mag-decide. And yun nga, if you decide, panindigan mo, this is worth it, di ba?
Right.
Ayun ang aking magandang takeaway dito, partner.
Ako naman, it's so important, and ang galing din ng pagkalatag ni Miss A, na you really have to learn how to take a break. I think lalo na ngayon na ganito ka-overwhelming yung napaka-abnormal ng sitwasyon natin ngayon. It's very overwhelming. It's very prone to yung description nga ni Miss A kanina. Yung malulunod ka na lang sa dilim, di ba? Hindi mo makikita. And how can you start, kunwari, to your point, Gerard, kanina na paano ka magkakaroon ng courage to move forward? Kung hahayaan mo lang na ayoko na pero lunod ka pa rin, 'di ba? That's why it's so important to pause, properly take a break, and reassess and reevaluate things. So ano ko lang, the three points that was very very resonant sa akin and something that I feel we dapat baunin natin. One, when you take a break, take the effort to change the way that you're thinking. So from a hopeless mindset, ilagay mo sa solutions mindset. What can I do to solve it? And then yung second, disconnect intentionally. Chumika, magkape, kumain, make sure it's not about work. There's a way to disconnect. And very, very interesting yung point number three, the best way to disconnect from work or yung lahat ng issues is to connect with other people. Talk to other people, di ba? Talk to other people, get to know what they're doing, just magchikahan lang kayo. Ayaw natin ng chismis na nakakasira ng tao, pero may mga chismis na nakakatuwa, di ba? Magkwentuhan lang kayo. And it refreshes, actually, when you're able to connect with other people. And that also goes the same way na when you're really down, na you're in a crisis and you're already too emotional to function. Yung tatlong way din na yon, changing the mindset, disconnecting, and connecting to others and allowing others to help you. Ganun din eh. You can apply it to any situation where you feel like you've reached the end of your your patience, the end of your emotions, di ba? Ang ganda ng pagkasabi niyan na if you are gonna quit, do all of these things first. Kasi these are the things that will enable you to move forward properly. Kasi hindi pwedeng quit lang tapos, sige, I'll figure out what to do. Magkukwit muna ako. De, yung maganda, yung you're able to quit with the strength to move forward. Diba? And moving forward, ang galing. Last point, yung hope. Clinging on to that hope, yun yung magpupush forward sa'yo na you will see better days and you will see a light. Diba? You'll see the shore. Even if you're already feeling like you're drowning, ako, yun nga eh, mm-hmm. connecting with other people, if you feel like lunod ka na, talagang na-overwhelmed ka na, allow people to pull you up then. Kasi sila yung may perspective from the other side of the ocean. Diba? So yun, ang ganda rin na.
Mm-hmm. De, tsaka yun nga, sabi, hindi ka nag-isa, hindi tayo nag-isa, we can always connect. Alam niyo mga ka-asenso, kami ni Mitch and some other friends, kami ang support system ng bawat isa mm-hmm. nung si Mitch ay nasa TV pa. So alam yun, maraming pwedeng tumulong sa'yo. And ito yung pinaka-importante, partner, siguro ang i-dismiss ng iba, eh, lagi naman sinasabi yan, pero alam mo yung pananampalataya talaga sa Diyos that mm-hmm. will see you through kung ano mang pinagdadaanan mo. Kapit lang doon sa kung ano mang faith meron ka. And you know, eventually this will all simmer down mm-hmm. at kung ikaw ay nasa gitna ng kadiliman sa isang karagatan mm-hmm. kalaunan ay mapupunta ka rin sa Pampang, di ba? Basta okay. kapit ka lang sa pinananampalataya, pinananampalatayaan mo. Naitawid ko yung Tagalog.
Correct.
Ayun,
may bonus ganun, question ganun ako. May bonus question ako para sa na umabot dito sa puntong ito ng video natin, no, 'di ba? Ikaw ba have you ever had that point na you had to quit something and yun, how did you move forward? Si GDP na mismo ang sasagot.
Ako ang sasagot?
Oo. Ako i-share ko muna. Syempre,
ikaw muna.
Oo, ako. Ako, I'll share this. Hindi na naman tayo umabot sa iba nating trabaho kung hindi naman din tayo nag-quit. I mean, I can't say na yung first job ko, yun na yun. Diba? Marami din akong dinaanan bago makarating sa kung nasan din ako ngayon. Ako, I will share na the pinaka motivation always for me to move somewhere else, sabihin natin job, ayan. Ang priority ko pal is knowing my priorities, number one. If you know your priorities, it's easy to decide, 'di ba? So my priority is health. So every time ano, yun nga alam naman ng mga ka-asenso natin na diabetic ako and there are other mga comorbidities ganyan. So pag nakokompromiso 'yon, kunwari masyado na akong hindi pa kasi ako ever nagka-quit na hindi ko gusto yung trabaho eh. It's always because napapagod physically at napupunta akong ER. So napapagalitan ako kaya nagka-quit ako. Ganyan. Pero it's always to the point na hindi ko na naaalagaan yung kalusugan ko. So yun yung usual trigger ko. Pero hindi ako magka-quit doon. Hindi ako magka-quit na, ay, na-ER ako bukas. Yoko na, bye-bye. It's always, ang ganda nung sinabi ni Miss A, that same mindset na, saan ako makakapag-enjoy pa sa trabaho ko na hindi ako nakakalimot sa kalusugan ko. So it's always that. What would it take? Ganda nga na sinabi ni Miss A, and I realized that it's something that helped me. What would it take para makapag-stay ako? Kasi I love communications, I love my job, I love this, ganito. Pero pag masyado na akong nakakalimot dahil nga gusto ko yung ginagawa ko, yun, I'm reminded of my priorities. But I think, I plan, I stay for a while. Kaya ba, di ba? Kaya bang, baka kailangan isipin mo lang, kailangan mag-to-do list ka lang. And then pag talagang nakokompormiso na, then I plan na, o sige, what would the next environment have to be like para hindi ko makompormiso yung kalusugan ko. And then when I find something, that's when I say, okay, I have to go. But at the same time, I don't like burning bridges. So it should always be seamless. Kaya dapat hindi ka emotional eh. Kasi pag emotional ka, may masasabi kang, mariregret mo, 'di ba? Makakasakit ka ng tao versus just making a decision that will be better for your health. 'Yun yung sa akin.
Hindi ko alam na ano, may sharing portion pala tong ano natin na nagulat ako ng slide. Hindi, sige. Obviously hindi ako nag-quit kasi hanggang ngayon ay reporter pa rin ako.
Yes, oo.
I think this year 12 years na ako sa TV5.
Wow! So that's
ako, ano na? Long time, 'di ba?
7
obviously
years
hindi ako nag-quit. Obviously, hindi ako nag-quit. Pero hindi naman kaila sa lahat na ano, ang daming beses ko nag-try mag-quit. But what made me stay? Kasi ang dami kong issues kasi, and yun nga, katulad ng sinabi ni ano, ang dami kong personal issues ha. Like may growth ba ako or ito ba yung gusto kong gawin? Daming eme. Pero at the end of the day, sabi ko na lang, ang prayer ko lagi, ito hindi etos to partner, you know me. Ang prayer ko lagi, Lord, I don't know what to do with myself. Ikaw na lang bahala. Seryoso, as in, I don't know what to do with myself. Ikaw na lang bahala. So, ang dami, di ba? Alam mo naman, namuntik-muntiga na talaga. Nandun na ako sa dulo. Isang perma na lang or dalawang perma na lang, di ba? Wala na. Ganito na ako sa TV5. Pero alam mo, I let the Lord lead me to where I am now, which is still here. Pero alam nyo, yung sinabi ni Miss A na, huwag mo isipin nagtsatsaga ka.
Yeah,
isipin mo, nilaban mo siya, ganyan, na hindi ka nagpapasensya lang. Hindi, pero alam mo nangyari sa akin, wala akong ganong mindset na, tsaga lang ako. Walang ganon. I love my job. Mm-hmm. I love TV5. I love what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
Pero alam mo, yung moment na hinayaan ko si Lord na siya yung bahala, ang daming doors na nag-open.
Correct.
Among those doors na nag-open, ito patapos na kasi yung term ko eh. Yung presidenta ako ng Economic Journalist Association of the Philippines. Next week mag-end na yung term ko. So, yun, thank you Lord for the open door. Pero alam mo, minsan napaisip pa rin ako, akin ba tong episode na to? Miss A, mag-quit na ba ako? Hindi, pero alam mo yun, ganun pa rin ang prayer ko. Lord, I don't know what to do with myself. Ayun na po, ang bahala.
Ang ganda rin, no, na diba? Yun na, yung faith na He will always lead you to good places. Oh, diba?
Oh,
to guide. And yun nga, yun, praying din talaga. Ganun, every big move, alam ni Gerard yan, kahit ako talagang pagdasal natin ng bongga to. And true. And if you know that the Lord will talagang lead you to good places, then it's so much easier to trust Him, di ba? And so much easier to plan around what He does in your life. So,
totoo yung sinabi ni Miss Jane. Totoo yung sinabi na ano, panghawakan mo yung whatever faith you have.
Mm-mm.
Yung pananampalataya mo sa Diyos, panghawakan mo talaga yun. And it will see you through. Kung ikaw ay feeling lost, o feeling mo, ayaw mo na, magkukwit ka na, or whatever, panghawakan mo yon and let it guide you to where you are supposed to be. Gugulat ka na lang. Ay, thank you Lord. Ganun ka na lang. Oo, panghawakan nyo lang yon. Ang hirap i-explain, partner, kasi iba-iba tayo ng experience, pero I just wanna tell our viewers and listeners at yung mga nagsumusubaybay sa atin na alam niyo, ano, totoo yung prayers. Hindi siya yung lip service lang na mag-pray tayo. Hindi siya ganun lang. It really works. So, I hope maging madasalin tayo, especially now, ang hirap ng mga ng panahon. Mas lalo tayong tumawag sa Diyos. Right. Mas lalo tayong tiwala sa Kanya.
Uh-oh.
Yun ang totoong tusi sa pag-asenso, mga kapatid. Correct. Mga ka-asenso. Diba?
Correct. Kayo mga ka-asenso, nasan kayo ngayong Enero 2022? Type down below. Are you on the verge of quitting? Did you find inspiration in this episode? Like, subscribe, and share. Kwento nyo lang sa baba at usap din tayo sa ating chat box. And hopefully, of course, our prayer and our wish din dito talaga sa ka-asenso ay simula pa lang nitong taon, maganda na ang takbo ng ating mga mindset para talagang pagising natin Disyembre na marami tayong nagawa, marami tayong nasolusyonan, 'di ba? At marami tayong talagang itinaguyod throughout this year. So if you are on the verge then of giving up and you're on the verge of, you know, you're just take a look at yung tips ni Miss A, and we'll also put her channel down below if you would need any more help. Yun, we can also help you out. Just message us privately. May mga ano rin kami. Sometimes we really just need people to talk to and people to help us out. Kapit tayo, we're here for you, sabi nga ni Miss A. You're not alone. Kung nanonood ka ng episode na to, kasama mo kami dito. So message lang down below. Let's connect with each other this year. And kaya natin to. Itaguyod natin na 2022.
Yes, this is our year and the following years.
Following.
All right. Mga ka-asenso, ang amin pong episodes, normally we drop the fresh episodes tuwing alas 12 ng tanghali pag Sabado. Kung naaalala niyo yung Oplan Asenso sa Radyo 5, 92.3 News FM, same time, normally. Pero pagka nalilate kami, abangan nyo lang po within the weekend, lumilitaw po kami. Latest na ang Monday, pero normally weekend. Ayan, so next week po magkita-kita ulit tayo dito po sa Ka-Asenso with Gerard and Mitch. Happy New Year! Ako po si Gerard de la Peña.
Happy New Year! Ako po si Michelle Orosa Ople. God bless mga Ka-Asenso.